kickoff right around the corner. Standing by to call the action, here are Brandon Godfrey and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, it's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. The scene in South Philly a few moments ago. And the city of Brotherly Love is fired up and saying fly, Eagles, fly as they get ready to match up with Andrew Luck and the Indianapolis Colts. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you look at this Eagles team as they interplay here. It's an early test here after two losses to start the season and a game they probably really need.
Obviously, no way do they want to get to 0-3. Not many teams make the playoffs with that kind of a start.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Colts, it's been a great start to the season. Back-to-back wins to begin the campaign.
Yeah, you don't want to get too excited. There's still a...
It's the first weekend of autumn, and the NFL is in full swing as off we go on EA Sports. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. So the Colts now coming out for their opening drive. And they'll be led out by their quarterback, the very, very talented Andrew Luck.
And it felt like in watching the game tape, he got everyone involved last week.
He was a manager.
He really was. That's a great way to put it, because they ran the ball some. They threw it accurately. One touchdown pass, so he didn't, you know, break the bank doing that. But he didn't throw any interceptions. That's the bottom line. That's why a defense loves a quarterback like that. Doesn't put them in bad situations.
On first and 10, Long. For the sideline, wow, what a catch there. He doesn't get a lot, but he was able to get the feed down complete. The completion good for 3 and second down. And we look now at the offense for Indianapolis.
Jack Doyle has to be one of the most unheralded players in the NFL. I remember when he came out of Western Kentucky, most thought he'd be the number 2, number 3 tight end on any team he played on. Instead, how about last year? 80 catches, second only to Travis Kelce of Kansas City. Named to his first Pro Bowl, that's what continued excellent play from him. Excellent route runner and a very good blocker as well.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A look at the numbers for Mac from last week. 22 carries, 79 yards.
And I'm eager to see how they deploy him in this game. Last week, a heavy workload. Do they decide to bring that down a little bit and try and keep him fresh? Or do they say, guess what? He's locked in. Keep handing him the football.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he'll be tackled right on the midfield logo. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's second and 2. You often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
From the 50, it's Long. Going up top. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position. Couldn't hold on. Third down. For the Eagles, a look now. The starters on the defensive side of the ball. And this unit, very tough to throw against. Currently second best in the NFL.
Yeah, defending the pass hasn't been an issue for them. It's been stopping the run. And if they don't stop the run, they can't get back to their strength, which is guarding against the air attack.
After the incompletion, here now, third and 2. First down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
First down, it's Long. throw left side is complete to Rodgers. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. A gain of six there on first. Was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. Out of the gun, and this time not quite to the 30, it'll be down at the 31-yard line. Good for a Colt first down. The former Ryan Ebron there bringing it in from Andrew Luck.
I don't believe that this opening drive is surprising to either one of us after the time we spent with the coaching staff and players prior to the game. What about you?
Absolutely. Not only that, but that big article in the paper this morning about their philosophy on starting games like you're shot out of a cannon, and that's what they've done. Very methodical here on this first drive.
Yeah, so many teams talk about that fast start. We're actually seeing it happen right here in front of us.
But now the kicker. Can they cap it off by putting the ball in the end zone? They go play action here on first down. He's going to be wrapped up and driven down. Fletcher Cox breaking through again for a loss of seven.
What a nice read and play by the defensive tackle. Never bought the play action fake, but picked the quarterback and put him on the ground.
Second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. They'll run it now, out of the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 4 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have to contend with a third and 13.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
Third and long, it's long. And this is going to be incomplete. So with fourth down coming up, here's Adam Vinatieri now for the Colts field goal. On the right hash, officially this will be a 51-yard attempt. And this is good. It was running out of gas there at the end, but he winds up getting just enough on it. And the Colts hit the scoreboard first. It's 3-0. So the field goal there caps what winds up to be an 11-play drive.
Well, partner, that's a lot of offense to run there to only get 3 points. So I just wonder, are they going to recycle those plays because they were successful in getting three? Or do you go to another section of the playbook trying to find ones that get you into the end zone and get you six?
So now here comes the Eagles' offense as they get ready to take over. Leading the charge under center will be their 6'5" quarterback, Carson Wentz.
And I saw that he had an interesting quote in the research packet that we had after last week's game. It's all on me now. I've got to lead my team and find a way for us to win a game. 0-2, but they're at home. I guess he's going to try and find a way to get the home crowd involved early.
Now a play fake here on first down. And now incomplete. Boy, they took a shot there on the first play, trying to start it out with a bang. But it's second down. And the tight end, Zach Ertz, is key in this offense as we get a look at the starters.
Comes out of the factory known as Stanford, which keeps putting out tight ends. Zach Ertz, one of the better ones we've seen in recent years.
Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10. Second down, Wentz. And he'll get hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. The starters now on the defensive side of the ball for Indianapolis. Against the pass, they're hoping to trend in the opposite direction because right now they're ranked number 26 in the NFL.
And even though that's not the greatest ranking in the world, one thing you can say, they get after the quarterback. They're the top 10 in the league in sacks.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. goes underneath for Sproles. They get 14 yards there and a first down.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production. But I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets at them and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
The numbers for Jeffrey from last week, 6 catches, 127 yards, and a score.
5th in the league in receiving yards, and that's a strong category. I mean, if you're in the top 5 in anything, I don't care whether it's football or tiddlywinks, you're having a nice season.
Man, not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Oh, fighting off the defender. Forced out to his left. And they're getting down as he's inside of the 40. So the youngster able to use the legs to pick up the first.
And one of my pet peeves when they see this guy play, when Carson Wentz takes off running the football, I always hear him go, oh, he's sneaky athletic. No, he's athletic. Watch him do it. He's an integral part of the quarterback run game, and he gets it done very, very well.
Yeah, you don't like sneaky athletic, do you? That's just kind of a jab in the back.
Yeah, not when it doesn't apply. I think that's a stereotype that needs to be broken down for him.
Now it's Sproles. And he'll be brought down just outside of the 30. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down. For this offense going forward.
Now they'll throw it. Wentz. Oh, it's over the middle. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. And Eagle first down there. Wentz to Ertz. And brings it in and TZ.
I do believe we'll see a little bit more of this as this game progresses, because when you can have that type of a game in the middle of the defense, it hurts them in so many ways, because most teams like to be strong down the middle. And if you can sting them there, that opens things up for you on the outside as well.
That's where he, their big tight end, is so good. That middle through the seam routes, the end routes. Yeah, you're right. Probably see more of that.
Yeah, it takes a lot of courage and fortitude to go in the middle as well. And he's got it.
From the red zone now, Williams. That's complete right around the 8. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. That throw good for 4. It's second down.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for good yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. Scores. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line.
Giving up respect to the big guys up front, because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large, and they've been barreling through them, picking up first downs.
Hang in there now.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he pushes forward but comes up short of the goal line as he'll get a yard down to about the one.
That run didn't get very far, and I think when you're looking at his dimensions, he's a little bit on the smaller side. He's counting on the big guys up front to escort him in, and they couldn't create any kind of space for him.
Didn't get the push they needed. Terrence Williams, a 1 yard touchdown reception, and the Eagles have taken the early lead. So second and goal there from the one, they go to the air.
And the perfect down to throw the football in this sequence. Second down is always kind of a. Do they throw it? Do they run it? They worked it out to perfection on that one by throwing it into the end zone.
On for the extra point, Jake Elliott. A good hold in these wet conditions. The point after is up and good, and that makes it a 7-3 lead. Kick this one away. The Colts offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they've got to make sure they love him up because he's up the mat.
Now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board. We'll see. And they'll wind up with about six up past the 30 to the 31.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That's good for an Indianapolis first down on a gain of 10. Getting the sense Charles are going to put big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
Now the fourth-year man from Texas A&M, Kristen Michael. And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. One quarter in the books. It's a close game here early on. And we're back to Philadelphia after this.
The NFL on EA Sports is fueled by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Back with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. The Colts in possession of the football to begin quarter number two. They've got a second down and eight to start things out. They'll try the air now with one. Going for Hilton, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Malcolm Jenkins. And he'll return this ball across midfield to the 47-yard line.
But Brandon, the passing game for both of these teams is going to be affected as the game goes along. It's not looking like the rain's going to let up anytime soon. So that might mean a few more wobbly passes and wide receiver slips. And this one winds up getting intercepted.
To take the field. But what do you think? You get the ball off the turnover near the middle of the field. You take a shot here on the first play?
You know I'm big on that. I love when I have great field position after a turnover. I feel like I might have them a little bit off balance. I prefer to take a shot, but a lot of coaches will tell you you only do it if you trust the guy who's got the football in his hand. Meaning, if it's not there, he won't force it downfield and maybe turn into an interception. He'll go to the check down, go to a second option, and go and take the play that's in front of him.
A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice, solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Scrimmage and he goes down right there. John Simon in on the stop.
perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
So third and two, this quite possibly four down territory, though, if they're stopped. They'll try and pick it up by running the option to the right. And he gets it to the 34, good enough for the first. 5 yards that time, taking it himself, and he has it up for the first.
Well, if you're going to run the read option typically, you've got to keep an eye on the defensive end.
And what does that mean? What are you looking for on the defensive end?
Well, you want to play off of what he does. If he collapses inside towards the running back, then you pull it and take it yourself outside in. If he stays outside, you go ahead and leave it with the running back. In this case, pulled it and got good yardage himself.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Try the ground game here with the running back. And a short gain down to about the 33. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, four plays in this drive, all four on the ground.
Here we go, back.
Now Wentz throwing on second down. A dump off the scrolls. A nice move he had, but can't break away. And he's brought down just inside the 30. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and they're going to have a third down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
On third down, a perfect 3 for 3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is third and 4.
Here we go.
To throw, it's Wentz. And Jeffrey's got it. And he will have the first before he's brought down on the chalk of the 20. An Eagle first down, Wentz hooking up with Jeffrey. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not let you run zone.
You have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front. Defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
And they'll go with a ground attack here. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
Well, that didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
In search of 8 yards on third down. They've already converted two of these on this drive. 2 for 2. Wentz going to throw. And fires one, but incomplete. Well, not to get too overcritical there because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right, that pass will go from incomplete to complete.
Now to try the Eagle field goal, Jake Elliott. This just a 35-yard attempt from the left hash. And the kick by Elliott is good. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. So the drive stalls out inside the 15-yard line, but they do get 3.
And I've talked with enough players nowadays, and when they have these types of kicks, that no one says to their guy, hey, it's just like making an extra point, piece of cake. Because the extra point is not a piece of cake anymore. But kicking a field goal from that distance, just give them confidence and let them knock it through.
This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. getting set to go again as we look at the back heading onto the field again. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the second quarter. What might they change offensively?
I think that what you try and do is expand how you get the ball to him a little bit. Get him out in open space, maybe swing the ball to him. What's that they used to call in the West Coast offense, the long handoff? Yeah. Serve as your running play that well, as well as continue to feed him the football. Some of these runs now may pop bigger later in the game because of the effects of running it. Sometimes people, after a while, they don't want to tackle him anymore, or they get tired, or they get out of position, or he runs through tackles. Continue to feed him the ball. He's having that kind of game.
Yeah, might they get him the ball in some space in some different ways here? Now a play fake, and it's long. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by the linebacker, Major Brown. And the return this time will go up to the 42-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they're throwing an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Sent to take the field. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. The best way to do it, touchdowns. But no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Right, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field has popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch it, no matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well. The Colts D sticking to their assignments, and that brings up fourth. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. From the left hash, this will be a 52-yard attempt. And Elliott puts this one through. And they will stretch their lead to 10 now at 13-3. They got the interception with very little movement after, and that forces him to settle for three. And it does feel like settling when that happens, doesn't it?
It certainly does, but we got to give a lot of credit where it's due, and that's to the defense, because they ran onto the field. It's what we call sudden change, right? Interception, you got to go put out the fire, and they did, holding them to a field goal.
That's fielded in the end zone, and no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. A look at the running back, the man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again. Now, I'm not going to say you completely abandon the passing game, but it would really behoove them to get this running game going more.
That's the identity most teams are seeking. Able to establish themselves, control the game by running it. Have to touch it multiple times in order to have success in this game.
As we say, that's right, as we say all the time, that sets up the passing game. If they have a broken record with that.
Listen, we can be broken records all we want. Bottom line is, lather up that big horse and let him run. Granted, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication, and as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating, there he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
They'll run it now, out of bounds, across the 30 to the 31-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup, that's going to set up an interesting third and about four to go. The completion on first didn't get much, and now the run on second doesn't get a whole lot either.
Well, if you're a good play caller, you've already looked ahead and anticipated this type of situation. Already down in his play sheet, trying to dial up a big third down play.
On third down, it's Mack, unable to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. That one for Indianapolis, resulting in 15 yards and a fresh set of downs.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Across the midfield stripe into Eagle territory. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to 2nd and 4.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between 2nd and 4 and 2nd and 8 and 9.
No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a 3rd and 4.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
From the gun on 3rd down, it's complete to Graham. And he will have a 1st down here at about the 40. His 1st catch, good for 8 and a 1st down.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the 1st down. And that's what he just did.
Coming up to the line, and they will need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Luck on 1st down. Jarred the ball loose and brings up 2nd down.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion, kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you can make a play on the football.
Now again, it's Michael. And he only manages a couple here, down to about the 38-yard line. 2 minutes remain here in the 1st half. We'll come back to Philadelphia after this. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL.
The Colts on 3rd down. They've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 8.
A shotgun snap for Luck. Finding a safety down here. That's complete. That'll be a pickup of just 2. And that's going to bring up a 4th down.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right to kind of play it into their hands. So out comes the field goal team now for the 2nd time here today. It'll be spotted on the right hash, a 52-yard attempt. Not going to get there. Not enough juice. An ambitious effort, but it's well short. And this score will stay right where it is.
And this is one of the risks you run when you attempt a long field goal. If you miss, the defense takes over the spot of the placement. So now they've got a chance to get one more drive in before halftime.
The Eagles' offense now, they head back on the field. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had a field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for 3, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes off to say, let's get 3, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
Given 9 there on the 1st down completion.
When you're a player of his stature, you don't just circle the games on your team's calendar. You
circle the Pro Bowl?
Without a doubt. That's a game that you just figure you're going to be in each and every year. That's because of catches like that. That's why he goes.
That last catch, short of the marker by just 1 yard, leaves him with a very manageable 2nd and 1. From the gun, it's Wins. Throwing for his running back, he's got him complete. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage if he has just a little bit of time to serve.
survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because they have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately.
Here we go, here we go.
They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
Now wins. From the slant pattern here for Brady.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
Wentz now 10 of 16 throwing the football. It's first and 10. Again, they'll throw with Wentz. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Working from the gun, Wentz. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. Nate Hairston there defensively.
This defense could use some more of these types of plays. How about him reading it, driving on the football, and he's right there for the pass breakup.
The Eagles on third down. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. This will be third and 15. Wentz now to throw. It's complete. It's throws. And whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. As he'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this first half.
Too much.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Again, it's Wentz looking for the end zone. And went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third.
Boy, you will not see a quarterback of his caliber miss on one like that very often. I mean, there it is, wide open, got the shot. And he misfires.
We talk about, boy, he'll want that one back all the time. He definitely wants that one back. Now Wentz on third down. And this is Ertz with it. Right side. And he's brought down. That sets up a first and goal.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one, and that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little game. Point. Elliott good on the extra point. a three-score game now. The lead moves to 17. So that was a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive. The result, Philadelphia in the end zone. Elliott now to kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Likely time for one final snap as they start out first and 10. Starting the drive with a give to Mack. And he'll get this one up to the 26. So we've come to halftime here in Philly with the Eagles on top as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
All right, Brandon, thanks. And welcome in, everybody, to our EA Sports Halftime Report. Time for a look around the NFL here in week 3 of the new year. We'll start our tour with a trip to FedEx Field, where we find Green Bay on the road to take on Washington. And it's the Packers who are out in front in the second quarter. Aaron Rodgers with 2 touchdown passes. Next, we take a trip down the coast to Miami to check on the Dolphins at home at Hard Rock Stadium. And they have the lead in that one over the visiting Raiders. Ryan Tannehill looking good. 2 touchdown passes. Finally, let's get down to Houston. Check on the Texans at home at NRG Stadium. And in that one, it's the visiting Giants who have the lead. Odell Beckham, a touchdown reception. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a back-and-forth first half. Who can put it together in the second half? For the answer, we turn it back over to our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. And they'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Out come the Eagles now as they'll go on offense first here in the third quarter. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive. As they score here, especially a touchdown, it's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And I believe the Colts have recovered. Yes, they have. Too tight in the rain?
I think that you can, and it's such a delicate balance too, because when you grip it so tight, sometimes it'll slip out from your body. You squeeze it too hard and it'll pop out on its own. I've actually had running backs talk to me about that, that when they've tried too hard, even in perfect conditions, the ball gets away from them. They've got to find that good balance, carrying it firmly, yet at the same time under control.
Took till the second half, but finally a red zone opportunity here. They come up first and 10 at the 16. Back to throw. Run. That'll be caught by Rodgers. A gain of 6 there on first.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe a little flexed out position, because he creates business. Doing the dirty work right there defensively. Second and short yardage, that's all about plugging those gaps, not giving the running back a crease to run through, and that's a nice job to hold him just a couple and force a third down.
Third down, it's Michael. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down.
And that's called winning at the point of attack, isn't it? Right there at the line of scrimmage. I know he's a little bummed out now. He doesn't get credit for a tackle for a loss, but no game, his guys will take that.
And speaking of winning, to be as cheesy as we can, he was the winner of the NFC Defensive Player of the Week award from last week, so he's really stringing together some good football.
So not only did he get a gold star, he might have gotten a gold watch too, huh?
And Vinatieri's kick is good. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in three. So a good drive there to begin quarter number three, but they're only able to shave 3 points off the lead.
Well, something's better than nothing, all right? They didn't play particularly well in the first half, but they definitely need them to step on the accelerator now and play a whole lot better.
It's Marcus Wheaton now to return it. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though, when they only gave up the field goal? And they were able to trot back out on the field and start this drive a little more pep in their step because they didn't cost their team a touchdown. But they know they've got to do it a lot better than they did on the last possession.
The coach will just be relieved though if they recoup with a score.
I think Coach will be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield and punch in the end zone without turning it over. Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Play action to Sproles. Wentz coming down he goes. Marcus Hunt in there to bring him down for a loss of seven.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
Coming up here on a third and long, so Wentz and company with some work to do after the sack.
There we go, back. Waiting.
Shotgun now for Wentz. Goes underneath for Sproles. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. 7 yards on the play, and that'll bring up fourth down. Instead of throwing it downfield, Charles, they just tried to dump it underneath there. You like the call?
I do. I think it's a high percentage play because you get the completion. What you're counting on is your back to use his legs and his elusiveness to make people miss and pick up the first down. In this case, it didn't happen.
Here's Donnie Jones now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return. And the Colts will go on offense here, first and 10. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the three-point
kicker.
Exactly. You put it through the post, that's going to help in their contract time. And that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
How about that? It helped in the contract time. You could have kicked that one through. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now, the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game.
Okay, he didn't break that one all the way, but you got to know that he feels like he's right on the verge, and that's probably exactly what he's telling them in the huddle right now.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Play action, it's locked. It's good. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
Well, sometimes our pregame meetings do pay off, don't they? What do the guys in the locker room call
him? Well, they said it with a chuckle. They called him unreliable.
Yeah, that means means he doesn't move quite as fast as he used to, but he still knows all the tricks, doesn't he? Even that little gentle push-off in order to get open, he finds a way to pick up a first down.
They go play action here on first down.
What has not been the best game for him, they definitely tried to get by with a little help from his friend there, trying to create a big play.
Couldn't do it, fell incomplete, but you're right, hasn't been a banner game here in the second half, just trying to get going.
Big thing is, try to keep confidence up and continue to fire.
Pick up!
They'll run it now, out of the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest game. Nigel Bradham brings him down.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down because they had the incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Throwing on third down. Sideline throw. It's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes inbounds. It'll be a gain of six, and it'll be fourth down.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
Now here's Rigoberto Sanchez, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. And problems spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly, so that'll come back to the 20. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. This crew had to punt last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you contend to play the field position game?
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead, you've been controlling the game. But why put them in a tougher spot? You want to get out there and get something done on offense and maybe take command of this game yourself.
Here's a handoff to Spurs to start the drive. And he's able to fly forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. Give him nine on the carry that time, and they're set up with a second and one.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Up at the 29 now, they'll head to the line, second and a yard. On second down, here's Reigns.
That was a pretty favorable situation there. What would you call that? Second and manageable? Smart play, too. Didn't force it downfield when he didn't have it. Just checked it down, let him get the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down.
Hey, don't go.
And on the ground they go with a running back. Spurs lost the football. And the Colts pick it up. And they take over. They'll set up shot at the 36-yard line.
All these years we've been watching the game, I started to get the sense that when it rains out, those guys have to touch the ball and carry it. They're extremely resentful about that weather.
Yeah, I'm just happy and not resentful that we have a roof over our heads. I know that much.
Yeah, maybe we won't fumble our play sheets here as we just saw the fumble happen on the field.
There again is the running back as he trots onto the field. And there are the numbers. Got off to that torrid hot start. We thought he was in for maybe a career day. Not the case.
No doubt about it. It almost looks like a misprint after what we saw in the first half. But let's give a little bit of credit to the guys on the other side of the ball. They went into halftime, made a few adjustments. And you know what else? They didn't lose their confidence in how their ability to play. Because a lot of times you get beat down in the first half, it gets ugly in the second half. They come out with a new resolve and a renewed determination.
5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
Two.
after the 5-yard completion on first down. From the gun, here's Love. And this will be incomplete. The turnover put him in great field position. They don't want to squander it with third down coming up.
No, not at all. And you know what else you do? You make your defense mad. Yeah. He got you the football, gave you a great opportunity.
Pressure comes and down goes. The Eagles get there with a sack. Fletcher Cox. And there to pick up his second sack now on the afternoon. Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. And a fumble last time. Ball security. Talk about it all the time in the National Football League. They've got to be better at it on this drive.
Don't you think that when every team gets together for the first time, I don't care if it's OTAs, mini camps, first day of camp in the regular season, ball security comes up about the seconds of the coach's address.
And there's so many drills focus on that.
All the time, and they do drills to make it even tougher to simulate game situations. Doesn't always work out, though.
Wentz will try again on second down. His throw incomplete. He was looking for Terrence Williams that time. And it's third down.
Well, they're slinging it. And then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown out of his reach and incomplete. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Wentz. Taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Your fifth catch of the afternoon, and that gives him a first down.
I don't care how many times we say it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass trick in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust. And that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Wentz now. 5 straight completions here in this second half. First and 10. They fake the give. Now Wentz. He's got it. And the Eagles add on to their lead. And there, a post round. Started out right, caught in the middle of the field, went into the end zone. What typically makes those successful, those deep post routes?
You need help from your complementary receivers, okay? The guy that you want to get the ball is the guy that we just saw catch it and take it into the end zone. So he needs help from the other guys who have to occupy anyone in the middle of the field. Whether it's one safety, sometimes you get two guys in there. Either run routes at them so they have to cover them, or somehow freeze them by running underneath them and hoping to draw them towards the line of scrimmage and throw it over his head.
Elliott Good with a PAT. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. So Andrew Reed with 4 plays. And it was capped off by an Eagles touchdown. Elliott now to kick this one away. This one fielded at the 5. And they finally get to him, but not before he's past the 45 to the 46-yard line.
We all know the teams never want to use the word panic. But if they expect to win this game, it has to start right here, right now. That return just set them up for points, and it needs to be a touchdown, not a field goal.
Luck and the Colts come up now first and 10 at their own 46. Out of the gun, Luck. And his throw is going to be incomplete. He was looking for Daniels that time, and that'll bring up second down.
And that's what he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there. Need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, we've got a couple more downs to play with.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. They'll run the man. And an alley to run. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. That one for Indianapolis and 15 yards and a fresh set of downs.
Man, these guys may not win this ball game, but you certainly can't fault the effort of this man here today. He's been a real thorn in their sides all afternoon. And that last carry puts him over the 100-yard mark.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Right back to him on first down. And this time they're able to bottle him up as they'll stop him at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
Joe was stopped on that play. He's had plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to him the rest of the game.
They'll run it now. Out of the gun. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down.
Well, we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Now it's locked. Over the middle, here it's Hilton. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say, I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Trying to get your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep down his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. Vinatieri now on to try to field goal for the Colts. They'll put it down right at the 40, so call this a 50-yard attempt. And Vinatieri's kick is good. And the drive will wind up yielding three. So his third field goal of the ballgame brings him a bit closer, but there's no question. They need to start turning some of these threes into sixes.
And sevens, and probably even eights. You know, as a kicker, you just head out when you're called upon, so he's done his job. It's the rest of the offense that needs to get it in gear. They want to close this gap.
Wheaton will return it. A little juke. Well, it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Wilson, the Eagles now with a first and 10, just shy of the 30. Wentz going to throw. Wentz over the middle. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. Three quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. It's the Eagles in possession of the football and leading this one as we get ready to start the final quarter. Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards.
Instead, they're letting him throw it because they feel that confident in what he's getting done.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And he's going to be brought down inside the 45 at the 43. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
And past the 35, will be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10.
Hey, back. 20.
And they're on it here. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there. Second down.
And the big fella stepped that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Play action. Wins.
There. He wasn't able to get it back, but he did have a teammate on the spot able to retain possession for them.
Eagles on third down. They've been really good converting 7 of their 10 tries. This will be 3rd and 15. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. A good pick up there, 7 yards, but it brings up 4th down.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid-type player. Half defensive back that covers passes and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
Stretch the lead up to 3 touchdowns now. It's a 21-point game. So it's 3 more points, and that widens this thing out even further here in the fourth.
And you know, in this league, you can never have enough points, but this widens it out, as you said. And now it's all about ball control, isn't it?
After the field goal, here's Elliott to kick it away. And the Colts coming out now. And last time, able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just, I like the way you described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker tried on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
They'll be going for 6. Over the middle, it's caught by Rodgers. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up 2nd down. Decent start to the drive, but let's face it, they need a lot of things to go right in a short amount of time, down 3 scores.
Yeah, they're going to run their 2-minute offense here in this game, but this is for future games. Can they get better and be ready for the next time? Hopefully with a chance to win.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a 2nd and 5. Throw on 2nd down is long. And a hit jarred loose. It's incomplete. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden the secondary. They feel good about what's going on. They just play better and better.
The Colts on 3rd down. They're right at about the league average, 40%, 4 for 10. This will be 3rd and 5. Luck now to throw. And that is incomplete.
Sometimes it's just not your day. There's another failure right there on 3rd down.
Desperation time for Luck on 4th down. And gets into the hands of Deion Kane. And he's going to have the 1st down at about the 38. But no reason not to try it there. And they do indeed convert on 4th. Felt compelled to go for it there on 4th down, trailing in the 4th quarter. They got it done.
And there's always a lot of pressure on a 4th down call. Doesn't matter the distance. Stuck to get it done, as you noted, and they did.
So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38.
No. Five.
On 1st and 10, Rock. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Doyle. Indianapolis moving the chains there on a gain of 12. You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off? Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And despite the good footwork, he'll be hit and dropped shy of the 45. Call it a gain of three, and that'll make this a second down. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just let him lead the game out that way.
Over the middle, complete. It's Doyle. And he's got this down to the 35. Another good reception there. The Colts on the march.
Like so many tight ends nowadays, they have no problem at all putting him in the slot and letting him go to work. And that's a nice pitch and catch right there for a first down.
It's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. So tackling almost on the spot, that means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it. One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and you can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
And he's got Rodgers. And he will have the first before he's brought down right on the chalk of the 20. What a methodical drive. This is turning out to be that time 9 yards, and the sticks move again.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Luck going to bring him up first and 10. And he's hit on his last 7 straight passes.
5-16!
From the red zone now, Locke. The kick is complete. And he lost the football. But this will fortunately wind up out of bounds.
And I have to admit, partner, that I've often thought that I don't like this rule. Where the offensive player fumbles the ball, goes out of bounds, and they get to keep it.
That's just because you're a defensive guy. That's why you don't like it.
Yeah, you're right. It is a slanted view, isn't it?
But this is where, for the offensive team, the sideline is their friend. Usually it's not their friend.
Yeah, exactly right. I actually played for a guy in college who needs to name the sideline. Sammy. Sammy sideline and use him well.
Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's 2nd and 10. So the false start will back them up 5.
False start. Offense.
And that'll set them back 5. So after the penalty, heading in the wrong direction, 2nd and 15.
Hey, green 80.
Luck throwing again.
Coaches never pull their starting quarterback, almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, I think he's going to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, and with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury. Look at the Colts looking for something big here after the sack. This is 3rd and long. Shotgun snap for Locke. And Locke will be intercepted for a 3rd time. Picked up by the linebacker, Jordan Hicks. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line. That's now a 2nd interception and as many reads from his linebacker position.
And think about all the different techniques he has to avoid in that situation. Is he spot dropping because it's zone? Is he picking up man-to-man? Is he
versatility and showing those hands. Here comes Eagle offense now as they get set to take over here. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that. They weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it. Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads. Bowled over a few people. Look at that one. Right up the gut.
Soft through three quarters. No reason to lighten up now. And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. It'll only be a gain of a yard, and it sets up a third down and four now. The Eagles on third down. They've converted seven times and could use another right now. This is third and four. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away.
Hang in there now. Hang in there now.
Now they try the right side here. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. And a loss of three to bring up four.
Yeah, let me puff out my chest a little bit, even though I'm not rooting for either team. That was a really nice defensive play. It's awfully fun to watch, even in an offensive game.
Here's Donnie Jones now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. Struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in the game like this, and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And the coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build.
Just something to build on. Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
Here's Luck now on second down. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he'll get it up a little shy of the 15. They'll spot him down at the 14-yard line. And 5 yards on the play there as the drive continues. Throwing is Luck. Staying on his feet. And this turns into disaster. He's not going to get forward progress. That'll be a safety. I'm not totally privy to what went on with their offensive meetings, but Charles, something tells me that one wasn't in the play.
Yeah, when we had our production meeting, they didn't exactly share that with us, but I'm pretty sure that on the play sheet, the run backwards into your own end zone play was not written down.
After the safety, remember, they also need to give up the football, and here's the free kick. Now Sproles. Checking the NFL scoreboard there in the fourth now in Minneapolis. And it was the Vikings able to take home the victory. Kirk Cousins, three touchdown passes to help lead the way. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here, and this game should be over.
And it's always the final play of preparation each week. The practicing of the kneel-down formation, the victory formation. We've got a game in hand, and that's all they're going to want to do now. They'll put someone back deep just in case something goes haywire. But all in all, take the snap, kneel down, and shake hands. Yes, get out of there. That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive game. Just keep that clock ticking.
Let's go.
Well, Charles, the forecast called for rain throughout the entire game, and we got rain throughout the entire game. But these two teams, they had fun getting dirty out there. They love the slop.
Did you trust the forecast ahead of time?
But when I saw just a big blob of green on the radar, I said, okay, let's trust.
Yeah, and that's why I'm glad you took my advice. Got your notes laminated, because you're an open-air booth. That rain can affect us as well, although not as much as the guys on the field. But let's face it, it's kind of fun to watch these types of games, isn't it?
It is. By the way, how impressive is it that you travel with a laminator? I didn't even know there was a portable laminator.
The things that you learn.
Golly, wise beyond his years. So for the Eagles, they're into the win column now as they move to 1-2 on the young season. And they will hit the road next week to take on the Tennessee Titans. Meanwhile, for Indianapolis, they suffered defeat for the first time as they dropped to 2-1. And they'll be at home next week for a date with the Houston Texans.